And praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him, who build the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives life to our day. To those who trust in his ways.
We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers, today the Church celebrates the holiness of Saint Dominic, a priest and the founder of the Order of Preachers, we normally called or known as the Dominicans. And so in this prayer, let us pray for all the Dominican family, especially the Dominican fathers residing here in Intramuros, the Lateran College. Let us pray that like their founder, they may always be preachers of the word. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy. Have mercy on us, O Lord,
for we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy,
and grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May Saint Dominic come to the help of your church by his marriage and teaching, O Lord. And may he who was an outstanding preacher of your truth be a devoted intercessor on our behalf. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their fathers, the day I took them by the hand to lead them forth from the land of Egypt. For they broke my covenant, and I had to show myself their master, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will place my law within them and write it upon their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer will they have need to teach their friends and relatives how to know the Lord. All, from least to greatest, shall know me, says the Lord. For I will forgive their evil doing and remember their sin no more. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall return to you.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should they offer a burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humbled. O God, you will not spurn.
Create a clean heart in me, O God. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, and he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. From that time on, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. "God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you." He turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, in the past 2,000 plus years of the history of the Church, from the very beginning at Pentecost until now, there had been so many men who tried to destroy the church. We begin from the Roman emperors, number one of whom was Nero. He persecuted the church. He burned Rome and put the blame on the Christians. There were many persecutions, and yet the church prevailed. And even in our modern history, people like Hitler, who said that he would destroy the church, the communist leaders, Stalin, and everyone else, they wanted to destroy the church. But did they succeed? No. Wala na silang lahat, nandito pa rin ang simbahan. You know, there's a story of one dictator who said to a bishop, "I will destroy your church." And the bishop smiled and said, "Good luck, no? We were trying to destroy it in itself, but we did not succeed." You know, even within the church, there were people who tried to destroy it by their lives, by their evil lives. Meron tayong mga papa, ha? Mga papa, popes, no? Na corrupt, no? May mga concubinage. I remember the story of Pope Alexander the VI. Nepotism, pamilya, ginagawang kardinal, no? Anak, ginawang kardinal. Kung babasahin ninyo ang kasaysayan ng simbahan, maiiskandalo kayo. Ha? May ganun bang papa? May ganun bang pari? May ganun bang obispo? May ganun bang madre? Oh yes, the church is full of them. And yet, the church still stands. Because that was the promise of Jesus in the gospel. The gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. Itatatag niya ang simbahan, at kahit ang impyerno, ang demonyo, hindi ito kayang itumba. You know, there is a lesson here. There is a special, important lesson here. Number one, if it is from God, you cannot destroy it. We cannot destroy it. Paggawa ng tao, madaling sirain eh. Pero kapag gawa ng Diyos, mahihirapan tayong buwagin. Kaya, that is one of the things that the church looks for, a person who would be canonized or apparitions. Sinasabi, ay, nagpapakita ang birhen dito, nagpapakita si Jesus doon, no? The church is very slow in making judgment. The church looks, no, into the possibility, gawa ba yan ng Diyos? Kasi kapag yan ay gawa ng Diyos, yan ay magtatagal. Totoo. That is the first lesson. If it is from God, no one can destroy it. The second lesson is this. We can trust in God's promise. We can trust in God's promise. The church says, that Jesus says, "I will be with you until the end." And we can hold on to that. Hindi tayo iiwan ng Panginoon. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, let us face life with hope. Let us face this day with hope. Kahit hindi maganda ang panahon, taglayin pa rin natin ang pag-asa, sapagkat alam nating kapag ang ginagawa natin ay galing sa Diyos, walang sino mang makasisira dito. Amen.
Please stand.
As we ponder on the foundation of the Church, we pray with open hearts to God the Father for our own needs and the needs of the world. To every petition, our response would be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Pope, the successor of Saint Peter, may use the power of the keys wisely and according to God's plan. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the power of evil may not prevail over those who maintain positions of authority in the community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all believers may never lose sight of Christ as the cornerstone and foundation of their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and the aged may be supported and loved by their families and friends. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have departed from this life may find rest in the kingdom of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, source of all wisdom, your Son entrusted this power to the Church. As we offer these prayers, help us to fulfill your plan for us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Attend mercifully to the prayers we offer you, O Lord, by the intercession of Saint Dominic. And through the great power of this sacrifice, strengthened by the protection of your grace, those who champion the faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, and Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Dominic, you bid your Church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May your church, O Lord, receive with wholehearted reverence the power of this heavenly sacrament by which we have been nourished on the commemoration of Saint Dominic. And may your church, having flourished by means of his preaching, be helped through his intercession. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus.